Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is April 9th, 2020. This is my 15th episode about the programming language C++ training standard. I will discuss what is the best way to learn C++ type system. The best way to learn C++ type system is experiment. Though the experiment sometimes may not give you C++ standard specification, but most modern C++ compilers are conformant to C++ standard specification. Through experiment, we can pry into or dig up any information about C++ type system. A couple of years ago, I filmed template metaprogramming episode 30 auto reference forwarding reference or R-value reference, decal type auto. If you want to watch this video, please double click it. This video is pretty long, almost an hour, 52 minutes long. 182 clicks, I got 3 likes. Some people are very patient as to watch 52 minute long video. Also, in episode 31, type decay and perfect forwarding, please double click this link. This video is even longer, over 1 hour long, and I got 4 likes. In this video, Mr. Rodolfson left a message. Hi Thomas, thank you very much for these unsung videos. I have a question regarding auto forwarding reference. As you said, auto forwarding reference can be L-value reference or R-value reference depending on the right-hand side of the assignment operator. In case it is L-value reference, could we still tell auto forwarding reference create an instance? I think we can't. So, saying auto forwarding reference create an instance is not absolutely correct. Correct me if I am. I will copy this part of message. Copy QA, paste it here like this. Before answer to this question, I will show my rule of thumb. Rule of thumbs. 1. Use auto for iterators in the STL algorithms. Rule 2. Use auto L value reference to enumerate elements of STL containers. 3. Use auto forwarding reference as the parameter types over lambda. Use auto reference to enumerate elements of STL containers in the ranged 4. Use auto forwarding reference as the parameter types of lambdas. Rule 4. Use auto as return type. When we return an instance using copy semantic or internally move semantic. For example, we can use auto as return type when we return an instance of shared PTR or unique PTR. 5. Use auto reference as return type when we return a data member of a class from a member function. Rule 6. Use auto R value reference as return type when we return an R value reference from an operator function. In rule 6, this arrow is R value reference. In rule 3, this arrow is forwarding reference. This arrow is forwarding reference as the parameter types of lambdas. In rule 6, this arrow is not forwarding reference, but R value reference. I will talk more about arrow forwarding reference or R value reference in near future episode. Rule 7, use decal type arrow as return type when rule 4, 5, 6 are not suitable. I will give you concrete examples for rule 1 through rule 7 in this or future episode. Don't get overwhelmed or disheartened with this rule of thumbs. These are my rule of thumbs that I gained through my experience. If you are new audience to this series of videos, the programming language C++ training standard, you have to watch my first episode, 00, install Microsoft Visual Studio, GNU G++ Clang, and Intel TVB by clicking this link. I create my videos in tutorial fashion. In tutorial fashion, I mean that I recommend you to watch this series of videos in the order listed in this playlist. By clicking this link, sourcecode.talkplayfun.com, in this website, please double-click CPP20 standard. Click this file, 014, remove CV reference T. Show in folder, unzip it, rename it, 15, auto, and decal, DECL type, hit enter. Copy the folder, paste it in your working folder. Start Visual Studio Code. Open the working folder. Select folder 015. Click this button, auto.cpp, hit enter. Control V. Include code talk play fun types. Include IO stream, auto, L value reference, C out, SCD, C out, auto, and L, SCD, and L, character, SCD, character, trace, character. Void, run, DECL type, int main, copy this function, copy, paste it here. Now I declare int a5 using type a, DECL type a. Using type a, p. P means parentheses. Decal type a. C out type of a. Talk play fun. Get type name. Type a. And then paste. I will fix it. Type A, type A, P, type A, P. Please note that I enclosed A with extra parentheses on purpose. Start command prompt, dir cd 015 auto and decal type C CL, EHSC, STD, C++ latest. It should be lowercase c. Or .cpp, fe, m.exe, hit enter. CLS M. Please compare this. In case of decal type A without parentheses, the return type is int. This declared type. The type of A with parentheses, return type is integer L value reference. Returns the declared type of an object. Returns the value category of an object. So A is L value reference. Parentheses returns the value category of an object. Now here int sum, int A, int B, return A plus B. Now here using sum T decl type sum, using return T decl type sum 1 2, cout type of sum T talk play fun get type name sum T, and then cout type of return T talk play fun get type name return T, and then now let's try with the GNU compiler dir cd 015 auto and decal type G++ STD C++ 2A auto .cpp LTBB LTBB MALLOC proxy O .gexe CLSG. In this case, decal type sum, sum is defined here, returns this function, function sums type. In this case, we call the sum with argument 1 and 2, return t is int, the return type of sum. Function sum. For example, double, double. If we build again, this time we will be using clang. Clang. Hit enter. CLSC. Now, in this case, sum's return type is double. Sum's function type is double int int. Please keep these points in mind. This experiment is very important. Returns the type of function sum. Returns the return type of the function sum. After 5 minutes break, we will do some shocking experiments with the keyword auto, auto L value reference, auto R value reference, or forwarding reference, and the decal type auto. I will see you again after 5 minutes coffee break. In this statement, A enclosed in parentheses, or parentheses enclosing an expression has special meaning in C++. Useful resources. Please double click this link. cppreference.com useful resources. If you scroll down, you can double click this link to open C++ 20 latest working draft. If you double click it, you can download working draft standard for C++ programming language dated 2020 January 14th. In this document, Ctrl F, primary expression, colon, hit enter. Then you can find primary expression. So, literal in C++, this and expression enclosed with a parentheses are primary expressions. Now, Ctrl F requires close, colon, hit enter. Then you can find requires clause. Requires clause start with keyword requires and constraint logical or expression. This constraint and the logical or expression eventually end up with primary expression. This primary expression, colon, hit enter again. We found it here. So any expression enclosed in parentheses are primary expression. Primary expression is quite useful when we define requires clause for C++ 20 concept. I will deal with C++ 20 standard concepts in near future. Now, write before function main, void, test, auto, and decal type auto. INTA 5. Constant INTC 5. Auto B A auto C D C. In case of B, the type of B is obvious. The type of B is the type of A, int. What about the type of D? In case of C, the type of C is constant int. What will be the type of D? Constant int? No, I don't think so. Now let's try it. Cout type of B. Talk, play, fun. Get type category B. And then cout type of D. Talk, play, fun. Get type category D. And there. Copy this function name. Copy. Paste it here. Disable it. Rebuild again. CLSM. The type of B is int. The type of B is int. The type of D is int. In case of D, C's type is constant int. Constant is dropped in this case. So, auto maps to int and constant int and ends up int. Auto is copy semantic. A new instance is created using copy constructor. Auto reference AL A. Auto reference CLC. What will be the type of AL? A is int. So the type of AL will be integer reference. Cout type of AL talk play fun get type category AL and there. In this case, cout type of CL talk play fun get type category CL and there. Now we build again the type of AL is integer reference. The type of CL is integer constant integer reference. There is nothing shocking in this case. Now, auto R-value reference. No, this is not R-value reference. AR A. Will it work? It works. Auto CR C. It also works. Auto RR 5. What will be the type of AR? Cout type of AR talk play fun get type category AR and then cout type of CR talk play fun get type category CR and then cout type of RR talk play fun get type category RR and there. Now let's do this experiment. Decal type auto DA A. Decal type auto DC C. Now here decal type auto DAP. I will copy once again DAL int reference A. I will delete this part for the time being. Now cout type of DA talk play fun get type category DA and then I will copy faced type of DAP. We can just say with parentheses 1A. So DAP. I copy once again DAL with a typecast DAL. I will delete this blank space, blank line. Now we build again CLSM. Now scroll up. Let's pay attention to this line AR. AR is integer reference. So, A is L value. A is L value. The type of AR, the type of AR is L value reference. Now, CR, CR is constant L value reference. Now, RR, RR is R value reference. This is R value reference with literal 5 because 5 is pure R value. Now, pay attention to DA. DA is int. When we use keyword auto, DA is int. DAP, when we use parentheses, expression is primary expression. In case of DAP with parentheses, the type of DAP is L value reference. Here, DAL, when we do typecast, the type of DAL is L value reference. So this statement and this statement are exactly the same with this experiment. Now scroll up. Here, DECL type auto DAC. C. I will copy this part. Copy. Paste. DAC. DAC. Now we build CLS M. C. The type of C is constant int. Using keyword auto, we assign the constant C to D. Then the type of D is int. Constant is dropped. Now here, we assign the C constant int using decal type auto DAC. The type of DAC is constant int. So decal type auto preserved constantness, preserved keyword constant. Now another experiment. Here, decal type auto R D A 5 R D A R D A. Now pay attention to these two lines. If we build again CLS M RR, the type of RR is R value reference. The type of RDA is int. Because value 5 is int. In this case, auto RR, its type is R value reference. Now another example, decal type auto DAR. STD move, we are moving A. Now copy this, paste DAR, DAR. We build again CLS M. The type of DAR is now R value reference. Now, our final experiment. Here, in this statement, the type of RR is integer R value reference. R value reference. RR is L value. Do not get confused. L value with L value reference. R value with R value reference. Both L value reference and R value reference are L value because reference means address or memory. L value always has its memory. But R value may or may not. Although R, R, L, R, R. We assign integer R value reference RR to integer L value reference RRL because RR has memory address because integer RR is R value reference. Reference has memory. I will copy this. RRL, RRL. We display the type. Also, see out the address of RR, address RR. See out the address of R, R, L, R, R, L, and there. Because R, R, L is L value reference of R, R, these two values should be identical because they are referencing the same object. We build again. CLSM. RRL, RRL is L value reference. RRL. The address of RR, the address of RRL exactly the same. I will arrange like this to align them. So, the address of RR, this R value reference, RR is R value reference. The address of RRL, RRL, exactly the same object. So, RRL, R value reference creates memory for literal 5. R value reference references to a memory location. R, R itself is L value or its value category is L value. See out the value category of RR using value category of R DECL type parentheses RR. Talk, play, fun, get type name, value category of RR. And there. Well, you can do the same like this. Get type category RR. We provide one more parenthesis. It returns value category. Rebuild once again. CLSM. The value category of RR is L value reference. Or we can do like this too. Scroll up. Here, the ECL type expression enclosed with parentheses returns the value category of an object. What this expression is called primary expression. Scroll down. We cannot remember the result of these experiments. All these results we can't remember. But there is an easier way that we can understand intuitively. After taking 5 minutes coffee break, I will explain with a few words that you can understand these whole things. I will see you after 5 minutes coffee break. I will answer Mr. Rodolphson's question first. Hi, Thomas. Thank you very much for these unsung videos. I have a question regarding auto forwarding reference. As you said, auto forwarding reference can be L value reference or R value reference, depending on right-hand side of the assignment operator. In case it is L value reference, it means the right-hand side of the assignment operator is L value reference. Could we still tell auto forwarding reference to create an instance? Can I understand like this? We can try it. In this function again, we understand A is L value reference. Here, auto forwarding reference A R L A, L, it does not work. A, R, L will end up as INT L value reference. See out the type of A, R, L, talk, play, fun, get type category. A, R, L, and there. And we can test the address of AL and ARL like this. See out the address of AL, AL, and there. I copy, paste ARL, AR, L. Okay, now second try. I copy this part, copy, paste. Now let's do typecast. Int, we do typecast. AR, RL, AR, RL, AR, RL. I will delete this part. AR, RL. Okay? We have done typecast. Now we build again. CLSM. Now here, AL, here, ARL is L value reference. AL, ARL, the same address, so the same object. I will put another space. CLS M. In this case, address is the same. In this case, address is the same. We failed. In this case, ARL, AL are the same object. referencing the same object. ARRL, AL, referencing the same object. The same address. So we failed. The answer to this question is sadly no. Now let me make conclusion of this episode. Keyword auto always creates a new instance either using copy constructor or move constructor and drops off constant. Keyword auto L value reference always ends up L value reference either constant L value reference or non-constant L value reference. Keyword auto forwarding reference ends up either L value reference or R value reference. C++ committee needed DECL type auto that can be non-reference types as auto and reference types as auto L value reference or auto R value reference or forwarding reference. I would call it auto 2% as generic reference. If you like my video, please give like buttons. Then I would create my videos more frequently. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.